क्वेश्चन नंबर 10 फर्स्ट पार्ट डील्स विद व्हाट? कन्वर्जन ऑफ, यस, कन्वर्जन ऑफ अ गैल्वेनोमीटर। टू एमिटर, दिस इज अ मूविंग कॉयल गैल्वेनोमीटर। द सेम डिवाइस कैन बी चेंज टू अ वोल्टमीटर और एन एमिटर, सेम कैन बी चेंज। सो हाउ वी चेंज इट इज बाय चेंजिंग द रेजिस्टेंस। यू प्लेस एट वन पॉइंट दिस वन, इट बिकम्स एन एमिटर। यू प्लेस एट दिस पॉइंट, it becomes a voltmeter. It is nothing but arrangement of a resistance. If you place a resistance in the parallel, it becomes an ammeter. If you place a resistance in series, it becomes a voltmeter. How? And what is the need? So this we can understand through an example. Here, this galvanometer is given to be what? What is the value of the same? Yes, galvanometer is, yes, 1, and resistance is, resistance of the wire is 1 kilo ohm and it is 1 milliampere. You want to change it to an ammeter of what rating? 0 to 1 ampere. So we purchase a galvanometer from the market, say this one. In this you have a moving coil. And you can see there is a movement of the needle also, that is by mechanical jerk, it should be by current. So you have a galvanometer, it has a coil, this wire, this coil is made up of a wire and it can bear how much current? Ig. Resistance is how much? Rg. How much current it can bear? Only 1 milliampere. So you can measure a current, even a galvanometer, this one you can measure current, but that value is how much? 1 milliampere only, very very small current. And this resistance is how much? 1 kilo ohm. Question number 1, why it can measure small current? Anyone? It is a capacity of the wire. If it is a thin wire, it can carry less current. If it is a thick wire, it can carry more current. So the winding, the wire, this wire is very thin, it can carry 1 milliampere current only. If you flow 2 milliampere current, then what will happen? Heat produced is more than its bearing capacity. It will burn, it gets damaged. So you can measure how much current? 1 milliampere. So at present this device can measure 1 milliampere current. And apa karna ki hai? Yes, we want to make it 1000 times. 1 ampere means what? 1000 milliampere. That is what we want to make. So the issue is same. You enter into a city, city has small roads, so there is a capacity for traffic, small volume of traffic can flow through the city. Then what you do is, yes, ki banaoge a bypass, so that major traffic passes through bypass. Here also what we are going to do is same. The value of current flowing here, which you want to measure, is 1000 milliamperes, and it can bear only 1 milliampere. So you want 1000 trucks to pass through city. City roads allow maximum one truck, say per second. then what is the method which you follow? That is, what procedure you follow is bypass. Bypass should have low opposition or more opposition? Low opposition, then people have a preference to follow that. So bypass should have some resistance, but this value has to be small. Let this value is RSH. SH means shunt. RSH we want to find out. Find R shunt. Now 1 milliampere can flow through this. What about the remaining 1000 trucks entering, one truck passing through the city, the remaining 999 will pass through shunt. Let this be termed as shunt current. And again you can see 999 is coming from this end, 1 is coming from this end. Total is how much? 1000. So how you change a small current carrying galvanometer into an emitter which can measure more current? Objective question number 1. What is the procedure to apply resistance in series or in parallel?
Parallel.
That value of resistance has to be small or large?
Small.
Then the next is numerical part of it. What is the value of a RSH? 10th class. Voltage across this, because the two are in parallel, voltage remains the same. So the working principle is voltage is V, that remains same. Voltage remains same because they are in parallel. If voltage remains the same, voltage across this, Ohm's law. Is equal to ISH RSH. IG is how much? RG is how much? ISH is how much? RSH we want to find out. When you solve it, RSH is equal to 1 milliampere divided by 999. Into 1 kilo ohm. 1 kilo ohm is what? 1000. By 999 is approximately equal to 1 ohm. No doubt it is slightly more than 1, but approximately equal to 1 ohm. Shunt of what order is to be placed in parallel? 1 ohm. If this is 1000, approximately 1 ohm, resistance is 1 by 1000, current is approximately 1000 times. So procedure is, when you want to convert a galvanometer low current carrying to high current carrying, ki karna padega? Bypass. For bypass, the resistance of the bypass RSH should be small or large?
Small.
How to find its value? Procedure is 10th class. Voltage remains same because they are in
parallel.
Then you apply which law? Ohm's law. V is equal to I R, I G R G, I S H R S H, and you can find out the value of a shunt resistor. 5 minutes with you to write. ऑब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चन, कंपटीशन क्वेश्चन. एन एमिटर गिव्स फुल स्केल डिफ्लेक्शन विद अ करंट ऑफ 1 एम्पियर. गैल्वेनोमीटर इज ऑल्सो अ स्मॉल एमिटर, सो इट्स मैक्सिमम करंट कैरिंग कैपेसिटी इज व्हाट? यस, 1 एम्पियर. And what is required is how much current you want to measure? 10 amperes. Question is, an emitter gives a full scale deflection. Full scale deflection, when it gives full scale deflection, when this device will give full scale deflection, when maximum current flows in the winding, maximum permissible current. Maximum permissible current here is 1 ampere. So, you got an emitter in the lab which can measure only 1 ampere, but you have an experiment in which you want to measure 10 ampere. So, you have two options. Number one, you go to the market, buy another emitter, 10 ampere, spend more money, or you can change, convert the same emitter of 1 ampere to 10 amperes by doing something. How can you change 1 ampere to 10 ampere? Yes, by placing a resistance in a parallel. If main wire carries 10 ampere, this can carry only 1 ampere. What about this one? 9 ampere. Question is what? Numerical number is? Find, yes, what? Ratio of resistance R shunt to R G, yes, R G, I will explain. One is R G to R S H, this is one. Sometimes they say find the ratio of resistance of two emitter. Which emitter? It is the original emitter, this is the final emitter. Final emitter RG and RSH are in parallel. So, question is not clear, last part of the question is not clear, but we will find, we redefine the question, find RG by RSH, solve it. R numerical is different from what is given in the book. Concept. Yes, Ig, Rg is equal to Ish, Rsh. Ig is how much? 1. Rg, Ish, 9. So, Rg by Rsh is equal to 9:1. That is question as defined by us. But there is mismatch. The answer given is different. Because as per the author, it appears ratio of resistance of emitter, which emitter, original or the final, small or the large, is not clear. Suppose it is the original emitter, then it is RG to the shunt resistance RSH, then the answer will be 9:1. If it is new emitter to RSH, suppose you want to find out this, what is the resistance of this new emitter, two resistances in parallel, that is RG into RSH whole thing divided by RSH. When you solve this, you can find out the value. Say RSH is 1, RG is 9. Suppose RG is how much? 9. RSH is how much? 1 over 9 plus 1 divided by RSH. RSH is how much? 1. Then the answer is what? Right? So, you have two questions. Because it is not clear, emitter means which emitter? Small? Earlier, I will say the original or the modified. That is not clear, that is why. Nothing to worry about. What you need to know is ratio. Galvanometer to voltmeter. Voltmeter which can measure from how much? 0 to 100 volt. First, when you buy a galvanometer, this one, it has a resistance RG. How much? 1 kilo ohm means 1000 ohms. How much current it can bear? It is also a small voltmeter. When you get a galvanometer, it can measure this much of current, this much of resistance. So, how much voltage it can measure? Voltage across galvanometer is equal to resistance into current. Current is milli. This is 1000. This is 10 to the power minus 3. So, it can measure 1 volt. So, when you use this as a galvanometer, it can measure 1 volt. This small galvanometer is a small voltmeter. It can measure small voltage. If you apply more voltage across this, then the current will exceed this value and the winding temperature will increase and it will ultimately burn. So, in the lab the requirement is, you have to measure 100 volt. So, again you have two options. One is to buy a new one. Agreed? Second is to modify this so that it can measure 100 volt. If we have to modify this so that it will measure 100 volt, then our resistance will be connected in series RS. So that this new voltage is 100 volt. If they are in series, the current is same. Question is, total voltage is 100, 1 volt is across this. What about this one? Total is 100, across first it is 1 volt, drop across a second. 99 volt. So, if it is 99 volt, the current flowing is same. Can you find out the value of RS? Yes. Find RS. Voltage across RS. 99. Voltage across S is equal to current, which is IG into RS. Why current is same? The two are in series. Vs is how much? 99 volt. This voltage is 99. You will get a very simple method to solve this. 1 milliampere RS. 1 milliampere 1 by 1000. RS is equal to what? 99,000 or 99 kilo ohm. Concept wise computation, it is very simple. This voltage is how much? This is how much? 99. How many times it is? Current flowing is same. So, resistance should be how many times? 99 times. So, for computation purpose, the calculation takes no time. This resistance has to be, if this voltage is 99 times, resistance has to be 99 times. If this resistance is 1 kilo ohm, it is 99 kilo ohm. So, how you convert a galvanometer into voltmeter? By placing appropriate resistance in series. There are inside this multimeter, there are resistances, number of resistances. When I place voltage, say this one, it will connect a resistance in a series. One resistance it will connect in series internally. This is 50, 10 ohm, 10 volt. Now it is 10 volt. Now it is 50 volt. You have increased the value of a resistance. Now it is 200. Same device, 200 volt, 1000 volts. Same device by placing resistances in a series. You can increase the voltage measuring capacity of the same. Time with you is 4 minutes. Question is numerical number 23. A resistance of 900 ohm is connected in series with the galvanometer of resistance 100 ohm. A potential difference of 1 volt produces 100 division deflection. In the galvanometer, find the figure of merit of galvanometer. We will work out what we mean by the term figure of merit, nothing to worry about. First part, a resistance of 900 ohm is connected in series. With the, yes, galvanometer. So, what is given is, all questions are of same type. It is numerical number 23. 900 ohm is connected in series with a galvanometer of resistance 100 ohm. RT is how much? RS 900. So, it will increase the voltage capacity by 9 times, 10 times total. If it is 1 volt, this is 9 volt. So, original 1 volt, now total is how much? 10 volt. It is 10 times. Agreed or not? If the original can measure 1 volt, the final can measure 10 times. A potential difference of 1 volt, 1 volt across what? Produces 100 division deflection in the galvanometer. You apply a voltage, total voltage of 1 volt. and the deflection produced here. The needle moves from original to final. How many divisions? 100 divisions. My question is, what is the value of Ig? First part, in order to find figure of merit, find Ig. Hint, Ohm's law, 10th class. Voltage is given. How much voltage? What is the voltage? 1 volt. What is the resistance? Total 1 volt. Total resistance 100 plus 900, 1000 ohm. So, current flowing is how much? Total voltage 1 volt. Total resistance 100 ohm plus 900 ohm, 1 by 1000 amperes. Agreed? 1 milliampere. 2. Total number of divisions, deflection, full deflection. 0 current, then Ig is equal to 1 by 1000 means 1 milliampere. When 1 milliampere current flows, it moves from 0 to 100 divisions. So, total number of divisions, how many? 100 divisions. 3. What you find out is, yes, figure of merit. We have not heard it so far. Now, we try to find from the text. Figure of merit is a ratio of these two. I do not know whether it is current by number of divisions or total number of divisions by current. Refer to the text, book dekho. Working of voltmeter. Working of voltmeter. Yes, ratio of current. Current of page number, refer to the page number please. 3 by 67. Page 3 by 67, it reads, where is it? Voltmeter, yes, figure of merit. K. K, underline K, 4th, 5th line, K, figure of merit of galvanometer, current for 1 square deflection of galvanometer, current per unit division. That means it is a ratio of current Ig by number of divisions. Current is how much? 1 milliampere, 1 by 1000 ampere. Number of divisions, 100 division. 1 by 1000 and 100, this is 1 by 10 raised to power 5 ampere per division. Can be written as 10 to power minus 5 amperes per division. So, new word, figure of merit. Numerical number 26. Minutes to try. Mark it as important numerical. Why? From one type you need to cover one numerical. for boats. Agreed? It takes into account both. Yes, galvanometer will be changed to what? Ammeter as well as voltmeter. Numerical is. The scale of a galvanometer is divided into 150 equal divisions. The galvanometer has a current sensitivity of 10 division per milliampere and a voltage sensitivity of 2 divisions per milliampere. How the galvanometer be designed to read 6 ampere per division, second is 1 volt per division. First, try to explain what the problem is. First part, you want to change it to an ammeter. Second part is you want to change it to a voltmeter. So, that means if you cover for board purpose one numerical, it covers both ammeter as well as a voltmeter. Complete concept. So, try. Try first part only, 2 minutes. Help. First part. The scale of galvanometer is divided into 150 equal divisions. So, number of divisions, how many divisions are there? 150. So, given is number of divisions, 150. The galvanometer has a current sensitivity of 10 division per milliampere. Property of this device galvanometer is 10 divisions per milliampere. Means when 1 milliampere current flows, it moves by 10 divisions. It moves 10 when 1 milliampere current flows. My question is Ij is equal to how much? What is its current carrying capacity? It is given 10 divisions, it moves 1 milliampere. If it is 150 divisions, yes, 15 milliampere. This is what is given. So, it can bear how much current? Ig is how much? 15 milliampere. This is given. What do you want to change it to? 6 ampere per division. You want to upgrade this to 6 ampere per division. How many divisions are there? 150. You want to change it to a new device of 6 ampere per one division. It has 150 divisions. 150 into 6, 900 ampere. You want to change it to 900 amperes. Fine. So, 15 milliampere current it can bear, you want to change it to 900 milliampere and 900 amperes. How? By placing a small resistance in parallel termed as shunt resistance. So, now this current is how much? 900. This is 15 milliamperes, means 0.015. So, the current flowing here is 900. How much moves through the galvanometer? 0.015. And here it is 900 minus 0.015. This is your shunt current. Total 900, 0.015 passes through the galvanometer and the remaining is bypassed. You have to find out what? RSH. One minute to solve. Procedure, yes. Ig into Rg is equal to ISH into RSH. ISH is how much? 900 minus 0.015. RSH we don't know, we want to find out. Ig is how much? Point, or all units need to be SI, 0.015 into Rg, yes. Given or not? We can find out. How? Because voltage sensitivity is given 2 divisions per millivolt. How much voltage it can measure? Maximum current it can bear is this much. Maximum voltage which this can bear is 2 millivolt per division. Yes, 2 divisions per millivolt. So that means when 1 millivolt is applied, it moves by 2 divisions. There are how many divisions? 150. So it is 75. So it can measure this voltmeter, this small galvanometer can measure 75 millivolt. Vg and Ig, 75 millivolt divided by 15 milliampere. Yes, Rg comes out to be what? Vg by Ig is equal to 75 by 15, 5 ohm. So resistance, this was 5 ohm. Find RSH. Find RSH. One minute for calculation. Anyone with the answer, please? 2, 3. Value? Yes. 8.3 into 10 raised to the power. Fine. Rest of the student can leave the calculation part. Second part is what? Yes. Second part of the question is what? You have to change it to a voltmeter. 1 volt per division. How many divisions are there? 150. You want to change it to a voltmeter. Of what order? 1 volt per division. 150 divisions are there. So, you want to change it to a voltmeter of voltage 150 volt by connecting a resistance in series. How you find RS? Yes. What was the voltage across first part? Yes. This voltage is of what order? 75 millivolt or 0.075 volt. This RS is how much? Yes. Voltage across S divided by voltage across G. Voltage across S is how much? 150 minus 0.075. Vs is I by RS. I by RG. Vs is how much? 150 minus 0.075. Vg is how much? 0.075. is equal to Rs, we don't know. Rg was how much? Rg 5 ohm. Solve and find. This comes out to be what? As per the book, this value is 9995. Please confirm. 9995 ohm resistance to be connected in series.